3 days on at the remote property where horror and heroism collided, the hunt for forensic evidence finally begins. Delayed until the bomb squad could sweep the home for booby traps.
As we're grieving, everyone wants many answers very, very quickly, but we have to be extraordinarily thorough.
Grief will be long-lasting for the families of murdered constables Matthew Arnold and Rachel McCrow.
The chat with the families was some of the most difficult chats you can have. They wanted me to know Rachel and Matt not just as police officers, but what they were like as children growing up and who they were as people. Even some laughs as they remembered their loved ones and some of the quirky things they did in life.
Specialist investigators examining how long the train's new police were coming to the compound.
This lonely dirt road was the only way in of Nathaniel, Gareth and Stacey Train, sovereign state as they called it. Remote, isolated and heavily fortified so they could protect it with deadly, murderous force.
Driveway barricades were designed to slow a vehicle's path, with surveillance cameras alerting the train brothers a car was coming. Seven News can reveal two foxholes were concealed under a mound of scrub with living quarters dug into the ground, including a campfire. Gareth and Nathaniel Train lay prone in full camouflage with rifles trained on constables Matthew Arnold and Rachel McCrow. Matthew was shot as he stepped over a wire fence. Rachel was wounded in the leg, making her own tourniquet. Keely Bruff dived for cover in long grass, while Randall Kirk's car was peppered with bullets as it screamed out of the property to call for help. One brother, likely Gareth, seized Matthew's Glock, used it to kill Rachel, stole their police radios to monitor movements, and set fire to their car into the scrub, trying to flush out Keely. Hearing the gunfire, then seeing smoke rise, Alan Dare and Vic Lewis from neighbouring properties drove to the front of the train's property. Alan had called 000 by the time he got out of the car. That's when he was shot, collapsing as he handed his phone to Vic, who fled, collecting Alan's wife, Kerry, from her home and meeting police. Alan, never to know who was really living next door, neither did those close to them.
It was a shock to the system that how can somebody that's we've known as a teacher, as a friend of the family, what made her tick? What made that switch flip? What happened?
The twisted tale of the conspiracy theorists said to be locked in a love triangle unfurling. Stacey left her marriage to Nathaniel to take up with his older brother Gareth. The mysterious off-the-grid trio worked in the education system in regional Queensland and New South Wales, a state where Nathaniel held a gun licence. Queensland police insist appropriate risk assessments were done with the information at hand.
There were no issues, no concerns about the officers going to that address.
Intelligence agencies also making inquiries. ASIO is monitoring conspiracy websites where the actions of the three killers are being praised.
Their security agencies are actively considering the implications of this matter for the national security of our country.
So a tragedy like this might be prevented. Now, Seven News understands that the coroner did visit the crime scene today because he wanted to walk through it himself, to feel it, to experience exactly what that crime scene was like. He wanted to get a feel of the temperature, the conditions there. He also wanted to make sure that he gave instructions to those investigators who were on the ground to make sure they get everything that he needs to make a thorough finding at the end of all of this, Max.
Steve Hart in Chinchilla.